Yeah. Hey.
Hey.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey. Yeah. We've been through a lot. Lord's willing, I'm getting my spot in the kingdom. We winning, no sinning, we not. I'm sending no praise to the men at the top. Hey, hey. Yeah. I just been thanking my God. 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 We've been through a lot. Lord's willing, I'm getting my spot in the kingdom. We winning, no sinning, we not. I'm sending no praise to the men at the top. Hey, hey. Yeah, I just been thanking my God, yeah. I just been thanking my God, yeah. I just been thanking my God, yeah. I just been thanking my God, ayy.
Why do the heathen rage? Cause we the anointed and I just been praying like every day. I need to meditate on what is important for me to survive in the daughter race. Why everybody vain? They want us up in that cage. I feel like sinning lame, I'm about to bring a change. Christ coming back, they gon' swim in flames. And I got this heat fall to my chest.
He said the name of Israel would no more be in your remembrance. So what did they do? When they colonized them, they said, let's call this entire group of Israelites Nigerians.
Salvation, that do not care about the kingdom of heaven, that do not care nor acknowledge your oppression. Your God is a black man, according to the Bible. It's written right there in Revelation. You understand? Now, let's show you who you are, Deuteronomy. I want to show you who you are. Where do you find Nigeria in the Bible? Deuteronomy 1, verse 1. We're going to go into the Bible and we'll prove everything. Do you see a pocket here? Do you see people dropping money here? Do you know why? As freely as you received. Read.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 1 and verse 1. These be the words which Moses spake unto all Israel.
Moses was speaking to you. People that call yourself Nigerians today. You are the Israelites. You were in slavery in Egypt for over 400 years. Now you're slavery again.
Read again.
Deuteronomy 1 and verse 1. Uh-huh. These be the words which Moses spake unto all Israel.
No, all Europe.
Unto all Israel.
All Igbo.
All Israel.
All Hausa.
All Israel.
All Fulani.
All Israel.
Moses, by the hand of God, spoke to Israel, the 12 tribes of the children of Israel. This will be. This is who we are. You have an imposter stealing your heritage. Read on. Let's go to Deuteronomy 28, verse 15. I said, I can show you who you are in the Bible. I can show you the oppression Nigeria is going through. You are praying. You are praying for greatness here in Nigeria. It will not happen. My father, do you hear me here? Sir, do you hear me? It says, we are always going to church. We are going to the mosque. We are praying for a better Nigeria. It will not happen until we turn back to our God.
Read the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments.
It says to do all his commandments, not his Baptist, not his Pentecostal, not his redeemed, not his Holy Ghost fire on the mountain, not his winner's chapel. It says to do his commandments. Thou shalt not steal. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Thou shalt not lie. Thou shalt not bear false witness against another. Thou shalt not kill. Keep the Sabbath day holy. Every single thing God told us to do, we broke it. And you think we will prosper as a people? Even in your house, you don't run like that. Read it again.
Deuteronomy 28 and verse 15. For it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
It says, it will happen in the future. You hear me? It says, it's going to happen when you do not listen to God to keep his commandments. What will happen?
To observe, to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses.
All these what?
All these curses.
All these what?
All these curses.
Listen. It's not your relatives in the village that is cursing you. You are under the curse of God.
That's right.
Because you don't do his commandments. You are disobedient. You are dishonorable. That's what the conviction that we are living in now is not what God called us to do. That's why he is punishing us. Read on.
That all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
Verse 33.
Verse 33, the fruit of thy land.
The fruit of your land. What is the fruit of your land? Is it just a cocoyam? Is it a plantain? Is it a cassava? It's deeper than that. Read again.
The fruit of thy land.
Your petroleum, your crude oil, your natural gas, your gold, your platinum, everything that is in this land. What will happen to it?
And all thy labor.
Everything you work for, your arrears of salary.
Shall a nation which thou knowest not eat up?
Who is the nation eating up all the resources of this country? Is it not the Chinese? Is it not the Lebanese? Is it not the British?
Right.
Shell said, oh, we're leaving Nigeria. For where? So that they can back outside and collect their oil outside offshore. Did they leave? Are they leaving? Are they is Shell still not collecting oil in this country?
That's right.
All your resources. A nation you don't know. Who have you seen from Britain? Who have you seen? But when you send your children to school, they're using what? British curriculum.
Yes.
Read it.
And thou shall be only oppressed and crushed always.
You're only oppressed and crushed always. Look at your condition. This is oppression. This is oppression. Yes. If you go to their country, they don't live like this. But they are practicing homosexuality. But they want you to believe in a white Jesus Christ. You hear me, Saint? Do you hear me? You're here practicing Christianity. Over in their own land, they're doing homosexuality against the word of God. You think they believe in God? Huh? Let's get another one. Verse 45.
Verse 45. Moreover, all these curses shall come. Verse 43. The stranger that is within thee.
What is a stranger? God says these are curses to identify who are the biblical Israelites. Today, how do you know who you are? You go to the Bible and you find out. You read about God said what happened to your forefathers. What is happening to you today? He says the stranger that is within thee. Who is the strangers in Nigeria? Do the Chinese come from Nigeria? No. So that makes them a what? A stranger, right? What about the Lebanese man that doesn't have a house? What about the Syrian man that cannot, his land is being blown up, but he's here in Nigeria. It says the strangers that are within your land, what would they do?
The stranger that is within thee shall get up above thee very high.
It says that the Lebanese man, it says that the Chinese man, the European man, the Syrian man, they will get up above you, children of Israel, very high. Read on.
And thou shalt come down very low.
Look at the condition we live in. Do you smell this nation? It smells. How do people live? This is worse than a latrine. How do we live in this condition? It smells so bad, we've gotten used to it.
Bring it up.
It's gotten so bad in this country. We have normalized oppression. We are normalized. Every 4 years, we want to come and dance around like things will get better. Playing politics. Politics was never our thing. This was what God gave us. Religion was not our thing. This was what God gave us. Commandments. Read on.
He shall lend to thee.
It says what?
He shall lend to thee.
It says that he will lend to you. Who is the he? The stranger. Nigeria, every single time, they're doing budget. They have to run to IMF. They have to run to World Bank. But all these resources in this country. Do you not see these curses? Who else is this happening to? Is this happening to the Europeans? Are they coming to Nigeria to come and borrow money? When you have all the riches in the land, you don't prosper, not one bit. Because you are the children of Israel.
Yes, right.
You are God's chosen people. You understand? But I said, make sure you collect his number. Make sure you collect his number so that you know that we have a school here in Lagos to teach our people back the way of salvation. You understand? Read on.
He shall lend to thee, and thou shalt not lend to him. He shall be the head.
He shall be what?
He shall be the head, and thou shalt be the tail.
We have become the tail. We have become the tail. We have become the bottom nation. Third world nation. Because we don't want to keep God's commandments. Verse 45.
Verse 45. Moreover, all these curses.
All these what?
All these curses shall come upon thee. And overtake thee.
The Sabbath. Oh, no. Brother Saint, you have to know what the Sabbath day is. You have to know. Because, give me Psalms 119, verse 5, verse 59. So, Zayt, there's things that we have to know. Drop that. Deuteronomy 10 and 12. Listen, Zayt, very quickly, I will show you. You understand? Because you now know that you're an Israelite.
Right.
You understand? You're a saint. Not just by name, but the biblical people.
Yes.
You understand? Saint is not some Catholic thing. You understand? Saint is biblical. That's what we were called. We were called the saints of God. You understand? And there's things that are required of us. Read.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 10 and verse 12. Uh-huh. And now, Israel.
Now, saint. Now, saint, listen.
What does the Lord thy God require of thee?
Your God is a black man. He said he requires something of you.
But to fear the Lord thy God.
Nigeria, it's time we fear God.
To walk in all his ways and to love him and to serve the Lord thy God.
How do we do that?
With all thy heart and with all thy soul. To keep the commandments of the Lord.
You see, Satan tells us, the Bible has all the answers. It says to serve God is to keep his commandments. Let's get the commandment. Exodus 20. I will show you. Today is the Sabbath day, and today at evening is the seventh day Sabbath. You understand? Because I'm sure you go to, what church do you go to? Let's put them on blast. You're Catholic. You know that Catholics started the slave trade? Did you know that? No, you didn't. The Catholic Church, the Pope, he's the one that started the slave trade, that rounded up your brothers and sisters from this land and sent them abroad to go work in slavery. And they colonized you here and took their resources. But you now, you see how you serve them. You understand? Because you serve them and you serve their God.
The book of Exodus, chapter 20 and verse 8. Remember the Sabbath day.
Saint, why does it say remember? This is the only commandment that starts with remember. Because you will forget who you are. And you will forget the commandments that God gave you. He says remember the Sabbath day. To do what?
Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy.
To keep it holy. You understand? What day is the Sabbath day, Saint? Saturday. You know the Sabbath day is Saturday. So why do you let this deceiving, lying Christianity pastor deceive you? Cause you to stay away from the laws of God. There's a way. Now, Saint. Yeah? So now you know the Sabbath day is Saturday. The Sabbath day is Saturday. Saint. Finish off.
6 days shall thou labor and do all thy work.
God gave us 6 days to do all our labor. All your hustle on Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday before sundown. To do all your labor, all your work, all your schooling. But the what?
But the seventh day.
But the seventh day, which is Saturday,
is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God.
The Sabbath of the Lord thy God. We are going into the seventh day Sabbath. Oh, you lying Christians that think you fear God, you disobey his commandments.
Right.
You understand? Drop that. Give me Hosea 5:15. Hosea 5:15. Things are going to get worse in this country. You see the inflation. Today you wake up before it's afternoon, the price of things have increased. Read.
The book of Hosea chapter 5 and verse 15. Uh-huh. I will go and return to my place till they acknowledge their offense.
In Amos, God said that he is in the midst of Israel, in Joel. In Joel, he said he's in the midst of us. When we were a prospering people, when we knew who we are, when we kept God's commandments, he was amongst us. But now, God is not in this country. God has left this country. You don't believe me? Let's see what the Bible says. Read again.
I will go and return to my place till they acknowledge their offense.
Father, till you acknowledge your offense that you have broke God's commandments. God is not in this country. Nothing will go well in this country until we acknowledge our offense that we have been liars, we have been cheaters, we have been adulterers, we have been thieves, we have broken his commandments. Read on.
And seek my face in their affliction.
I told you things are going to get worse in this country. If the Bible says things will get bad in America, you think Nigeria will stand? If the other Western world, things will get hard. You think Nigeria will stand? You think your politicians will save you? You think your team will save you? You understand? You better acknowledge that God is a black man. You understand? You better acknowledge that you are the children of God. And it's time to keep his commandments. Read again.
The book of Hosea 5 and 15. I will go and return to my place.
God said he will. But Father, come. Let's give you paper. Yes, listen, he said, I will go to my place. You hear us, ma'am? Look at the condition your children are living through. You don't want to understand why, how you can save them. Read.
Till they acknowledge their offense and seek my face.
How do you seek God's face? Go to Isaiah.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 34, and verse 16. Seek ye out of the book of the law.
You hear that? He says, until you seek my face. How do you seek the face of God? Out of his Bible.
Yes.
That's how he... This is the only authoritative word of God. You will not find anywhere else where it declares God's face. Read.
Isaiah 34:16. Seek ye out of the book of the Lord and read.
And do what?
And read.
Nigerians, you like to read anything but your own book. This sister, I have a question. My sister, walking away with the blonde hair, I have a question for you. Just 1 minute. It says that we need to seek God's face. It says, no one of these shall fail. None of the prophets or the prophecies that God said or the curses have failed. Did we not go to colonialism? Did we not go to slavery? Are those things not written in the Bible? How long shall we wander to and fro around the same mountain? Read.
No one of these shall fail. None shall want a mate. For my mouth it hath commanded, and his spirit it hath gathered them.
His spirit have gathered them. Let's go back to Hosea. It says, his spirit have gathered them. The Spirit of God through the apostles have gathered these words to show you that God is a black man, that you are an Israelite. It's time we come out of all this idolatry. It's time that we come out of all this idolatry that we are in, following false gods.
The book of Hosea, chapter 5 and verse 15. I will go and return to my place till they acknowledge their offense and seek my face. In their affliction, they will.
What?
In their affliction.
In our affliction is when we are being afflicted. Read.
In their affliction, they will seek me early.
We're supposed to seek God.
Is men leading by example. Nation is family. Nation is community. Nation is children with role models.